Great War began in 1914 until 1918. The U.S. did not partake in the war until 1917. Wilson asked Congress to declare war after intercepting a telegram asking Mexico to declare war on the United States. After joining the war, the United States changed dramatically. America mobilized the Selective Service. All men ages 18 to 30 were eligible to be drafted into the military. Women began filling men positions in industry jobs. Women also began to enlist in the Army Corps of Nurses to tend to the wounded. The American women started gaining rights such as the 19th Amendment, which allowed them to vote. Not only did women change during the war, but African Americans did too. The Great Migration allowed African Americans to move north to fill vacant jobs in industry and join the Great War. Over 367 African Americans joined World War I. After the war, many women and African Americans faced job displacement. Many Americans feared the spread of communism. This is called the Red Scare. The U.S. would be later faced with the greatest economic recession of its time. After World War I, the economy was booming due to the increase in jobs from the war. Henry Ford was introduced and changed the workers' facilities forever. He created the assembly lines and brought cars to lower-class families. Also during the 1920s, broke out a consumer revolution. Families could afford goods and the stock market seized record high numbers. Installment buying was invented, suburbs began to grow due to the increase of automobiles. Also during this time, modernism versus fundamentalism, which brought the Scopes monkey trials. Prohibition and crime was famous during this time. It brought the ultimate bootlegger, Al Capone. Pop culture was born, radios, heroes, art, and flappers is really what made up the Roaring Twenties. The Great Depression began in 1928 after Herbert Hoover was elected president. The Roaring Twenties hid the struggling agriculture and uneven distribution of wealth. Americans' debt grew to the strike-it-rich mentality of the Roaring Twenties. The stock market finally fell, leaving it known as the Black Tuesday. In 1929, banks begin to collapse and the Americans lose their money. The world has led to a worldwide Great Depression. In 1933, unemployment rates in America spike and the government began bread lines for their starving people. Americans began to lose everything and live in makeshift homes. These clusters of homes are called Hoovervilles. A drought chokes the farmers and creates a dust bowl. People are on the move for a search of better conditions and jobs. Hoover acted out to save his Americans by creating public works programs. Just waiting for bread. Once I built a railroad, I made it run, made it race against time. Franklin D. Roosevelt is elected president in 1932. FDR created an idea to pull America out of the Great Depression. It becomes known as the New Deal. His New Deal consists of an emergency banking bill, Agriculture Adjustment Act, TVA, PWA, and fireside checks. The second New Deal was aimed towards elderly, poor, and unemployed. Things began to change culturally. African Americans began to vote, welfare was recreated, radio, movies, and music became popular. Two is a war of dictators' aggression for power. The war was Axis versus Allies. The Axis was made up of three dictators, Hitler, which was striving for inferior race, Mussolini, which had dreams of an Italian emperor, and Georgia, which sought to control all of Western Pacific. The Allies' strategy was to unite and win against the enemy. The United States did not join the war until 1941 due to the Japanese attacking Pearl Harbor. The U.S. strategy was to win the war and overwhelm the enemy. The industries were booming again. Women worked in tough conditions making ammunition and weaponry. African Americans returned home to the start of a civil rights movement. The U.S. ended the Great Depression. After the war, the Allies formed United Nations Universal Declaration of Human Rights and the Nuremberg Trials, which were held for German war criminals. Company jump when he plays reveille. He's a boogie boogie bugle boy, a company bee. He was a boogie boogie.
good boy of Company B.
During the 1950s, America was recovering from the result of World War II. We created the GI Bill, which allowed veterans to have a job, college education, and housing loans for a year. 8 million vets took advantage of the GI Bill. As a result for the returning troops, the population increased dramatically. This is known as the Baby Boom. The Civil Rights Movement slowly began to rise by desegregating the U.S. military in 1951. The suburbs exploded with Americans. Nearly 40 million Americans moved. William Levitt created a prefabricated home, which made homes more affordable. In 1950, an Interstate Highway Act was created, and it was funded to build 41,000 miles of highway. The famous American attraction, Disney World, was introduced. The first computer was invented, and franchises such as McDonald's were too. Americans began enrolling in college, and graduate rates increased. Russia launched its first satellite in 1957 called Sputnik. Medical innovations such as vaccines were created in 1950. American dreams were born culturally, economically, and socially during the 1950s. The Cold War began in 1945 and lasted in 1963. It was a war between capitalism and communism. America changed in many ways. Socially, the Cold War created an overwhelming fear of communism. This is called the Red Scare. Different individuals were on trial for spying, such as Julius and Rosenberg. America changed politically by forming a relationship with China, who changed economically from the relationship in China and increased trade. To feed in the ghetto. Now people, don't you understand that y'all need to hear? Not only were African Americans affected by the Civil Rights Movement, but Americans were too. It was the first time in history we all tried to come together as a whole. Both African Americans and whites organized and led the Civil Rights Movement at a national and local level. Martin Luther King helped them pursue their goals through legal means, negotiations, petitions, and nonviolent protests. In 1960, four African American college students set a Woolworths lunch counter and refused to leave until served or arrested. Later, the Supreme Court ruled that transportation and all alike must be desegregated. In 1961, members of Congress of the Racial Equality set out to test a new law by riding two buses from D.C. to the Deep South. In 1963, Martin Luther King leads a peaceful march on the nation's capital. More than 200,000 people showed up. Martin Luther King gave his I Have a Dream speech, which was given at the Lincoln Memorial depicting a colorblind society. Vietnam started in 1955 to 1975. The purpose of this war was to contain communism. During the war, many anti-war activists in America did not support the soldiers in Vietnam. Many young men were drafted to fight in the war. The University of Michigan were the loudest anti-war students organization. The violence erupted during anti-war protests. Many Vietnam soldiers began to see a lack of support from their country. They began to get taunted and looked down upon. The Vietnam War helped push the counterculture to what it is known today. The increase in technology is a large factor.
Americans began to see the horrors of war. It gave them a true taste of reality and pushed them to become anti-war activists. Not only were Americans able to watch what was going on, but now they can be easily influenced by the government, media, and society, and they're now more vulnerable.